I just want to show them the video of the fight.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do we have it?
Yes.
All right, let's pull that up. All right, guys, so this is the fight, right, between them. As y'all can see, let's play it from the beginning, please.
Yes, sir.
So they're here in New York City, right? Obviously, an argument happens. He's trying to put her back in the vehicle, right, because he tries to leave. She wants to follow him. He's like, hey, I'm leaving. She chases after him, right? And you can see he's trying to get away with the chick or from the chick, right? And this started because allegations of him cheating on her. Right. She took it. She tried to take his phone from him and he took it away. He pushes off her. My man is running blocks.
Running for his life, bro.
Yeah, bro. Like, what the
he
hell?
He is running
man?
For his life, bro. He said, no. White woman, stay away.
Yeah, she's chasing him in Manhattan.
Running for his life, bro.
Still going.
Bro, he's running fast as hell.
Yo.
Too.
Yo.
He clearly,
well, yo, he's to be fair, bro, yo. He is black. Yo. I mean, this is expected, bro.
Anyone saw?
I mean, if you think about it, bro.
She's going into traffic and shit. She's.
Yo,
what the hell, man?
Yo. He's clearing it.
So y'all can see here that clearly, right? They got an argument. She wanted his phone. He runs from her. He tries to create distance, right? And he tries to put her back in the car because she wants to chase after him. And obviously, she's been drinking too, bro. And y'all are going to see this as well. So so this is what it is, right? And this comes from TMZ, this footage here. But yeah, dude, look, you can see. And he's like, fuck this shit. And he runs, right? And he pushes off of him. She keeps going. My man ran a couple of blocks.
He ran blocks away, bro.
Ran blocks from
for
her, bro.
For his life. So you're telling me, is he somebody trying to beat somebody up or run away for his life?
So let's make this 1.5 speed. This is right after the news broke that he got found guilty.
Yeah, Mo, you good? You're gonna be crying over there.
Nigga saying, shut the fuck up, bro.
Crying over there.
Yo, Rumble going crazy. Come on, bro.
I gotta pee.
You gotta pee, okay.
All right. All right.
That's funny.
And hello, everyone. I'm Kira Phillips.
And I'm Terry Moran. We've got some breaking news. The jury in the Jonathan Majors domestic violence trial has found him guilty of one count of assault and one count of harassment, but acquitted him of another count of assaulting his former girlfriend. This comes after jurors spent 4 or 5 hours deliberating over portions of several days. And this is a case that has gotten a lot of attention.
Fair
Jonathan
use,
Majors,
use,
a major
fair
rising
use.
Star, and he met a crisis in this, and the jury has now returned with his verdict.
And there was a lot of talk about this trial impacting his future in the movie business. Rising star within the Marvel movies. Our legal contributor, Brian Buckmeyer, has been following this from the very beginning as well. So I guess let's first of all talk about the charges here. Brian, your first reaction.
Yeah, I'm actually kind of scratching my head just because I'm looking at the different charges, and let me break it down and explain. There are two different assaults here. One is intentional assault and one is reckless assault. Based on the number order that they're telling us, my guess, and please someone correct me if I'm wrong, is they're acquitting him of intentional assault, but finding him guilty of reckless assault, meaning that he just did something he should have known better and it caused the injury of Grace Jabari. Then he's found not guilty of aggravated assault, which is to
Bills, do me a favor if you can
threaten someone pause. And subject them to physical.
Do me a favor, bro. Can you pull up her injuries? Because she did have an injury, I think, to the back of her ear when he tried to put her back in the vehicle. Because he lifted her up and I think she hit her the back of her head or like her ear in the vehicle. And also, just so y'all know, she's very fair-skinned, so she's going to bruise easily, right? And that obviously doesn't look good for him whenever a girl has any type of bruising, even if it wasn't like that serious. And people, because that's one of the biggest things when they look at domestic violence is, oh, do you have any bruising or anything else like that? Which you don't even have to touch someone like that. Some people are very bruised easily, and you could literally touch them, and they'll just have
especially
a mark, and then bam. Now that's evidence against you.
White girls.
Yeah.
They bruise easily.
And she's pale.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it is what it is.
She can even make it up. Honestly,
that too.
Hit herself.
Hit herself.
He did this to me
because the cops came hours after the fact, right? So after he ran away from her, guys, she went to the bars, right, with some random people that met her, and she drank, and then she ended up at his apartment, and she was like in the closet, lying down and shit, drunk as hell. So he called 911, and he got arrested, bro.
Wow.
Yep. Yep. She basically went into his New York apartment, hotel, because I think they were visiting. After the altercation happened, he ran away from her. She went to a bar, was drinking, etc. Then, after the fact, she ended up at his hotel, and she was in the closet. He obviously scared. He's like, what the hell? He calls the police, right? And he ends up going to jail that night.
Imagine you're calling law enforcement to protect yourself, and they protect somebody else that's harming you. That's crazy, bro.
Wild, right? Let's go ahead and continue on.
America, bro. Cool. Wow.
violence, but he's not guilty of that. But he is guilty of alarming and annoying Grace Jabari. To me, this sounds like a, we call it a King Solomon decision. It's like they literally just split the baby and said half and half. But some of the convictions and some of the acquittals don't really make sense when you put them all together.
Well, Brian, let me try to make a little sense. I wonder, I don't know the exact fact pattern since I wasn't in the courtroom, but couldn't you say that in the fury of what is a domestic dispute, he was reckless in his handling, in his physical handling of Jabari, and that was the reckless assault, and the harassment is he lost his temper rather than consciously went after her. Does that make sense?
No, because it would make sense for the reckless and then the aggravated harassment, because the aggravated harassment is harassing someone through physical violence. So why find him guilty of assaulting recklessly but not guilty of harassing someone through physical force?
Thank you.
That's the part that I'm thinking someone just kind of said,
common
you know,
sense.
Why find him guilty for
oh,
two?
Oh, man, there's the injury right there. It could back work. Of her ear. And then her finger.
Jury, I guess.
Yeah. Let's talk about the evidence, because there was clearly
those
clashing
the
narrative
photos
from
they
both sides. We had video, audio, text, photos. Do we have that? Video. Okay, this is some of the photos that we had here of the bruises and the cuts. This is the video that I'm talking about. I mean, this was probably one of the most powerful pieces of the evidence that they played in court, Brian.
Absolutely. And I was in court watching some of this video being played to the jury, and I think it was difficult for both the prosecution and the defense to really articulate this video in a way that really moved the jury. And I think ultimately, the jury kind of took this case into their own hands. We saw that from the jury notes saying, we want all of the evidence, pretty much video, testimony, 911 calls, and they decided for themselves. For me, is this Jonathan Majors assaulting his then girlfriend, then running away? Or is this him trying to stop her from stealing, or I guess re-stealing his cell phone and getting away from her? The juxtaposition of how this was presented to the jury, I think, is what caused the deliberation to take so long.
And there's a state of mind, obviously, that the prosecution would have to prove, right?
So those are the photos that they admitted into evidence, right? And this is really bad, man, because like I said before, this puts him in a light as an abuser, even though, and I want to let you guys know this as well, there's a law in New York where you have the right, okay, to defend yourself if your personal property is being stolen, right? For all intents and purposes, her taking his phone from him is a crime, or trying to get his phone from him. And he has the ability, right, to defend himself and protect his property, which means using physical, I don't want to say violence because it's not necessarily violence, but using his physicality to defend his property. He has the ability to do that according to New York law. But of course, it's a court of public opinion. They're going to go ahead. And it's interesting because I want you guys to see here how the Manhattan's DA's office painted this entire case. They brought in other information that had nothing to do with this particular argument to paint a picture of him as a controlling, abusive boyfriend.
So we saw the skit, which is pretty funny on some level, but serious at the same time, because look at it this way. You're in a car with your girl. You're in an Uber. You know, you're in their car driving, whatever. She sees your phone, assumes that you're texting somebody, or maybe sees a photo of another girl, and then gets violent with you in the car. What do you do? Obviously speaking, this is similar to what happened to Chris Brown with Rihanna, 6ix9ine, his girl, and now Jonathan Majors and his girl. And it's kind of like, okay, whatever you do, can you actually win in a scenario? Because you can't defend yourself.
Yep.
Because you might damage her, you might bruise her, and then what's kinda the grounds like to like even like get away? He ran away, bro.
Yeah.
He ran away and still got convicted.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Now, granted, I just want to make it very clear. These are misdemeanor charges, right? They're not that serious. He's probably not gonna do no jail time for this stuff. They're lower level misdemeanor charges. But the stigma of being an abusive boyfriend or domestic violence, it never leaves you regardless of how frivolous the charges are. And him being convicted will make him look bad. I mean, at this point, he's been convicted of a crime of misdemeanor violence, domestic violence. He can't even get a gun anymore now because of the Lautenberg Act.
Especially, I hate to bring this into race, but being a black man, they're going to push that to the actual limit.
Well,
it sucks, bro.
Yeah, that could be a part of it. I mean, she is a white chick, too. I mean, white women are definitely, they get away with murder out here,
bro. Bro, to be honest, bro, not to be like in the weeds here, if she was black, you wouldn't see no bruises. Hey, man, get a fucking car, bro. You'll be fine, but hey, man, that sucks, bro.
Man.
Sucks. I'm just saying, Mo.
Yo, man, that would have been funny.
But yeah.
Okay, let's see here.
Shaniqua.
But
this is one time where Shaniqua would actually.
I mean, it's two protected classes. You got white girls, then you got a nigga, man. I mean, it's two classes that are going to be kind of protected in New York that's super woke.
Bro, but this is why, like, okay, I get the whole thing about, for example, she was bruised. Understandable. Was it him? We don't really know. However, in this scenario here, bro, this is what I would have did. I would have started recording from my phone everything that was happening and run away. I think what he might have. Well, actually, to be fair, he didn't know what was going to happen. Him trying to put her in the car was him being safe with her, in my opinion, him being safe with her. So you know what? rather than leave you following me in the street, stay in the car. I'm going away.
Yeah.
And we saw all the time on the show.
Yeah.
If a woman's hitting you or abusing you,
great
walk
distance.
Away.
Yeah.
That's what he did.
Yeah.
But in the jury's eyes, putting her in the car was assaulting her.
Yeah.
Isn't that crazy? Man, this is a crazy world, bro.
Yep. Let's go back to it.
Gotcha. So, it's wild, bro.
Yeah, but no, he definitely lost his Second Amendment rights now too, guys. Because the Lautenberg Act, if you are convicted of a crime of domestic violence, yeah.
And he lost brand deals too.
Yep. Man, New York City's trash, bro. All right, let's keep going.
And Florida. So here they are. She has seen the spark that triggered this fight when she saw what she thought was a message from another woman on his phone. So she was trying to grab the phone. He's trying to grab it back there, probably at the peak of emotions and anger and mutual conflict at that point. And would the jury have factored that in? In other words, we've all been in fights with people we love, and so it's not the same as a more conscious.
As Brian
conscious
smiles, he's like,
yeah. So this is the difficult part for me. And this is where I was getting in trouble at home when I tried to break this down to my wife. What I didn't like about this defense is they didn't focus on what is called Penal Law 3525. It's the ability to use force to stop a larceny or theft.
Bam,
or criminal mischief to damage your property. And I always go back to some.
So he actually cited the law. Yes, you. And this is, I mean, every state's gonna have this. You have the ability to protect yourself when a crime is being committed afoot on you, right? Especially if a crime of larceny or robbery or whatever. And that's basically what she's doing. She's trying to take his property with force. That is the definition of robbery, my friends. You know, so, and that's the biggest thing with typically compared to larceny. Larceny is like just theft, right? When I worked in loss prevention, robbery is typically theft with the with violence. And that's what she's doing. She's trying to take his personal property through physical force. That is robbery, my friends. And he has the ability to defend himself. And he actually cited the law. I think he said 25 or something like that of New York Penal Code. But yeah, dude, let's.
I wish we knew why she wanted to take his phone.
Well, we know. Because a girl was texting him. She wanted to see.
But she's probably seen that before, though. Why this time?
I mean, it's probably a recurring issue. I mean, bro, this is what I tell y'all, man. Just be honest with these hoes, man. God damn, bro. Like, what the fuck do I tell y'all, man?
So, you were right. I'll tell you this.
Like, you just told her, yo, I'm going to have other chicks. It is what it is. You ain't going to be dealing with this fucking stupid shit, bro.
You know what happens, bro? And you called it before on the show. A guy of that status with the other girl, tell her you're the only one.
Yeah.
And this happens all the time. Now, mind you, she's of the opinion.
And she's mid as fuck, too. So I'm not surprised.
Hold on. He's mine. He ain't going nowhere. So I'm good. She has the big checks. Sees your lifestyle. I'm set for life. Then she sees, texting other girls, liking the pictures on Instagram.
Yeah.
Oh, hell no, nigga. You're mine. So now, what did they do? Resort to violence or trickery or bribery. And what happens is, for the most part, we've seen it with Chris Brown, 6ix9ine, they start hitting niggas. And obviously speaking, as a guy, you get hit on, damn.
I got some crazy stats for you guys on domestic violence here in a second, that I'm going to reveal after we do this.
And unfortunately, in this scenario, the guy doesn't win because, again, any abuse to a guy, how do you fight back?
Nobody cares.
Nobody cares, bro.
And no one even points out the fact that Rihanna started the whole fight with Chris Brown. She was beating the hell out of him first.
And granted, let's say she had his phone or whatever, right? How do you combat that? You just grab it from her hand? She might get bruised. How do you even, like, get out of that scenario? It's tough because, I mean, we could say one thing right here on air, but, like, in that scenario, what do you really do?
That's why I tell y'all, man, be honest with these girls, bro. Like, especially if you got shit to lose, like, just be honest about it. Like, you're going to have multiple chicks or whatever. You avoid these headaches, right? Like, you sell the dream, that's fine. But when you sell that dream and the girl feels as though that dream might be taken away from them, they're going to do crazy shit like this, chase you down 5 blocks and try to start a fight with you and all this other shit. Like, crazy, bro. Crazy.
She saw the bag running away in real time.
Yeah.
She saw the bag doing like this.
Yeah.
The bag is running.
Because she's a failed actress, just so y'all know. She's an absolutely failed actress, a fucking nobody.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So for her, she's like, what the hell's going on? I gotta go after this nigga, man.
He was in a movie for real.
Yeah, man.
Goddamn.
All right, let's
Kang
let's keep
running
going.
Blocks away?
So he had 3525 is the ability to use force to stop a larceny.
The Conqueror Kang running away.
Analogy that I've said multiple times in ABC. And I'll use Kira, use an example. If Kira's walking down the street and someone takes her purse, the law says you're allowed to use force to take your property back. The law doesn't say, well, your girlfriend's allowed to take your cell phone because she's allowed to check for infidelity. The law doesn't say, well, my wife's allowed, or I'm allowed to take my wife's property because I need to check it for this or that. No. To me, this broke down to Grace Jabari stealing property and Jonathan Majors using force. Now, the question is it appropriate force to take back his property? But that seemed to be an argument that was missed completely in this trial. I'm not sure quite why. For the most part, they really focused on, can you believe that these injuries actually occurred in that...
I'll tell you guys why. And he also didn't take the stand, which is very important. You guys want to know why? His defense had two issues. Mm-hmm. Number one, they had to defend him, right? In a court of public appeal in Manhattan, one of the most liberal jurisdictions that you can ever have, that's super pro-female, mm-hmm. right? And they obviously had a hard-on for Jonathan Majors because they're going to get clout off of this. They want to make a stance against domestic violence, etc. So that's one thing. Then also, they had to protect this public image. Mm. Okay? So they're doing a dance where they're trying to defend him in court while simultaneously protecting his public image. Could you imagine if they said, well, my client has the right to use force on this 110-pound white female to get his phone back?
It's over.
It doesn't look good.
It's over.
Optically, it looks bad.
Yeah.
So they have to go off of the frame of, he was trying to run. Look, Your Honor, my client ran 5 blocks from this crazy bitch, right? But that's not enough because there's no context as to why he was running and why he did what he did when he put her back in the car and why the physicality was used. But they didn't want to do that because, again, he's a Hollywood actor, A-list actor. They don't want to put him out as a perpetrator of violence, even if he's in the right to do so, by the way, because his phone was being stolen. And his defense team, right, I gotta say, like, they have a difficult situation because not only are they defending him, right, in a criminal court, but they're also defending him in the court of public appeal,
yeah.
And he's an A-list celebrity. I want y'all to go back. I want y'all, after this podcast, take a chance. If you guys want to see how fucking controlled a lot of these actors are, watch Joe Rogan's podcast with The Rock. The Rock made zero concrete stances on anything. Rogan talked more than The Rock. Now, with that said, I grew up watching WWE. I'm a fan of The Rock, but I lost a major amount of respect for him because he's controlled, bro. He's absolutely controlled. When you're an A-list celebrity and you're getting doing big movies like this, etc., what you say, how you behave, your viewpoints, etc., you can't have that. You got to be in the middle or politically correct if you're going to err on one side. You got to be more woke than real. And that's what it is once you get to that level of fame and that level of Hollywood. And it sucks because I grew up watching this guy, you know, in the 90s and the early 2000s, land of SmackDown and saying all this crazy shit. He ain't like that no more. He can't. Hollywood controls you once you reach a certain level. And Jonathan Majors obviously is at that level now. Obviously, he's at the beginning of it, but his legal team had a very difficult task. They can't sit there and say, well, my client has the right as a 220-pound plus African-American man who's in great shape, by the way. Watch him in Creed 3. Fucking huge, right? To use force against this 100-pound fucking woman. No, bro. It looks bad optically.
Could we argue that he was concerned about her safety by putting her in a car? Could we argue that?
They don't like how he did it.
See, it's not what he did. It's how he did it.
It's how he did it.
How?
Yeah.
Yo, bro, that's crazy. How do you win that?
Yeah, you can't. That's what I'm trying to say. And on top of that, he's got to protect his image, so they can't even use that defense that, like, yo, you have the right to use physicality to get your property back. They can't even use that. The defense didn't even use that in the trial. And on top of that, he didn't take the stand, right? Now, I know what some of you guys are going to say. Well, you know, the right to self-incriminate, you know, you have the Fifth Amendment right to stay silent. You don't have to take the stand. In a situation like this, a lot of the times, and the people criticize Tory Lanez for this as well, for not taking a stand.
Yeah.
It's a hit or miss, right? But the way he looked at it was, if he took the stand, it would have opened him up to them asking him questions or cross-examine about his relationship with his girl, what he tells his girl, etc. And you guys are going to see here that he wanted her to be to have a certain image, not embarrass him in public, etc. Things that, like, I think are very plausible as an A-list celebrity guy, like your girl can't be doing certain shit. And they would have used that against him to paint him in the light of an abusive, controlling boyfriend. So I can see why he didn't take the stand. And then on top of that, that's a pure nightmare from him from an image standpoint. Again, guys, it's a two-pronged issue. He's not just trying to defend his freedom here. He's trying to defend his image. And as an A-list celebrity, you got to be squeaky clean, no real stances, nothing.
Yeah.
Watch The Rock's interview, and you guys are going to see exactly what I'm talking about. Nigga can't take an opinion on nothing, bro. On nothing.
Dude, the moment they got the verdict for this case, bro, instantly, what did Marvel do? Drop. Done.
And these are two low-level misdemeanors, FYI.
Yeah.
They're not. They're bullshit misdemeanors. He ain't going to do no jail time for this, but they dropped them because the image.